Nithyanandam, can you hear me? Nithyanandam, is it clear now? I want to make sure before I start. Yeah. Thank you so much. Let's start with the Guru Vandanam. Let's sit straight. Visualize Swamiji in the third eye. Nithyanandam paramasukadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gagana sadusham tatvamasyadi lakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvadi sakshibhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami. Nithyanandam, welcome to Kailash Courtyard, Manifesting Power Session. Welcome all the God and Goddesses, all the Paramashivas, all the states, space and powers and super consciousness of Paramashiva. Ma, you're not able to hear?
Oh, no, sorry, Ma. It was something Ma Joyce. I wanted to get the playlist for the recorded session. So sorry about that. I meant to message her personally.
Okay. You are able to hear, right?
Yes, I'm able to hear.
Yeah, okay. Because we've been having technical problems, so I just want to make sure. So I'm going to share the beautiful slide of Maha Sadashiva, the beautiful state, space and powers and super consciousness, the Deva Rahasya that Swamiji has shared with us, the ultimate space that Swamiji has given, which is only known to Brahma. He says this is a Rahasya, this is a secret, only known to Brahma, that he is sharing with us. He says so beautiful, all the five faces are five faces of Paramashiva. The phases are phases. Manifestation is a manifested. Manifestation is sustained. Manifestation is destroyed or rejuvenated. Manifestation is pulled out from delusion and manifestation is liberated. He says constantly, the one is tied up with the other. The Pi of Paramashiva, he explains as a software code. If you ask him, what is the software that he is using for Windows 10? This is exactly the software, the Sankhya. The Sankhya is the software he is using in here so beautifully for us. All this is happening inside each one of them. If that doesn't exist, that itself gets destroyed. For example, rejuvenation is destroyed. If it is not, rejuvenation is not destroyed, the samhara is not destroyed, then samhara will destroy everything. Understand? Every action has to have the action of itself and the other four components. Then only the whole pi of Paramashiva is maintained. If you see, it balances beautifully. The crisscrossing balances itself. The beautiful space, Swamiji says, all this is happening now. Let's listen to that two things which he keeps on repeating. He's actually repeating something constantly with all these things. What is he repeating again and again? He's saying, all this is happening now. And if you understand the now is the energy space, not matter. He's very clear. In now, we are energy. In now, we are Kali, Kala, the Hiranyagarbha of Paramashiva, the zero TPS, the space where creation happens, not Sunya, but all this is happening. That's why he wants to say it is not nothingness. the nothingness, all this happens. Usually we are in thoughts, constantly bombarded with thoughts, because we believe the thoughts has raised us so much. But in spite of thoughts, we've been raised. That is the truth. The thoughts are matter. Matter attracts matter. That is why the whole universe, the sun attracts the moon and gravitational pull is happening. The medium is gravitational pull. And whole matter is attracted with more matter. The whole cosmic world where the sun, moon, Jupiter, all the planet is attracted by sun as gravitational, because earth element, manifestation, the first phase of Paramashiva, which is matter. The matter attracts more matter. If we just live in matter, earth component, it is only thoughts, that's all. We are humans. We raise ourselves to the next space, the now, which is happening every moment. Everybody, every now it is happening. It is completely without thoughts, completely undisturbed. It is our decision to be there or not. Now is an energy space. It does not have weight. It does not have weight. Swamiji was given this great science by Raghupati Yogi, that he understood that just simply live in now. Yes, unclutch from anything you know other than now, and live in the moment, moment to moment to moment. And he says one more thing. He just doesn't say just now. He says, Smarnat Mukti. That means without any gap, contemplate these truths. Like you're breathing. Do you have gap? Okay, now I'm so tired, I'm not going to breathe. We don't have. Heart is beating. Even when we have a surgery, heart is beating. It is beating more fast sometimes. So there is no vacation, no gap for heart. There is no gap for sunrise. There is no gap for the waves which are happening. All natural things happen simultaneously, spontaneously. Understand? All the nature, if you see the nature, so our nature is also constantly living in the now, in the higher dimension, and constantly contemplating on these truths. I am Paramashiva. I am Paramashiva. Chanting the Mahavakya again and again. Like the breath goes in and comes out, constantly chant the Mahavakya. Constantly without any gap. That's what he says, without any gap. Again and again he says this, if we listen, all this is happening in now without any gap. The context is Paramashiva. The context being Paramashiva, I am chanting Mahavakya again and again and again. The Big Bang and black hole is happening again and again and again in now. I have to initially start it, like how I learn cycling or swimming. Initially, I have to start it. It might be a struggle. Again and again, we have to do, oh my God, this is too much. But once we start again and again and again, then we fall into such a beautiful space of complete oneness, where it's not nothingness, but so much of creation, delusion, regeneration, sustenance, liberation is happening. Create the whole creation world, we start understanding. Oh, that's Purnatva, the fulfillment. How much ever I go and fight my health or finance or whatever, I am not going to be fulfilled. But here, once I get fulfilled, it becomes very easy that I can fulfill anything, because I know I am the creator. I am the Paramashiva, the Brahman. I am the creator of what is happening. So I create, I destroy, I sustain, I deluded, I liberate. It becomes the Paramashiva possesses us. Right now, the mind is possessing us. Swamiji many times says, I just let Arunagiri possess me. That's all. I become him and he becomes me. That is what he says. Will you become me? Simply, if you live these states of consciousness, it is you becoming him, Paramashiva. Then all the things that we understand fall into place so beautifully. The now and without gap. That is the only way we can get out of this delusion. Initially, it might look, oh my God, lot of work. No. Once you start doing that 21 seconds, Swamiji says, so beautifully, just 21 seconds. If we break, we are enlightened. That constant remembrance, that is why a child is able to do. Whether it is Nachiketa, Prahlada, Lavakusha, all our children, Andal, all our children, below 18, below 10, some of them, if they can understand what they can understand, a child, live in the present moment, yeah, they are already in the present moment. Okay, now chant the Mahavakya, simply you'll be enlightened. They just chant. For them, we can't put delusion in it. If you see Gurukul kids, that is why they're so powerful. They cannot have incompletion because constantly they are given all these truths right in young age. And they're told, see, kids always get the best. From young age, I've told instead of focus on the, you know, start understanding pain. Instead of that, start healing. I'm telling, go on healing. They know they can heal. If they heal 10 people, they know they can heal their body. So they never fall sick. They just know it because they do it. Same thing with pain. They see 10 people, no pain. They also know, hey, if you fall down, you have to heal. Why are you crying? They know very well. Because of all this way of life, the powerful cognition that Swamiji is drilling into them through satsang every day, they have to be enlightened being. Because as children, they will take only the best. See, if they are in, suppose they are in Croatia, they will learn the language. You can't stop them from learning language of Croatia. You can't say, no, don't learn the local language. By a child, it will automatically learn. Parents might not learn. They can live 10 years, they will not learn. But a child, first week, they'll come and tell few words and say, see, I learned this local language. Because they're so excited about learning. They are not, intimidated. Like that, we just live in the moment. Again and again, remind yourself. Again and again, go back. This is the rahasya. We want to get beyond all the problems. Get out of this delusion. I want to wake up. I want to become Paramashiva. That is the simple integrity with Guru. The identity that you declare. That is the beautiful space. So here you open up and say, I want to be Paramashiva. That is what Swamiji said. I am always questioning him. He is not obliged for anything. He is consciousness. How can I go and ask consciousness any question? He is not obliged with anything. I am obliged. First, I have to declare. I have to surrender my problems and raise myself and then look at him. I am saying, solve my problem, but I will not wake up. Then how will he solve? Wake up is the solution. So wake up from what the delusion is. Wake up by being in the moment to moment to moment. Every moment is the rahasya. Every moment is the rahasya. And without the gap, smarnat mukti, constant remembrance liberates. When you remember Guru constantly, you get liberated. The whole thing, whatever around you, simply start changing right now. Because now if you change one of the component, even now, you're changing. Your delusion is changing right now because you're deciding to be in the now. So everything, the pie of Paramashiva changes. Immediately you'll see everybody so beautiful with you. Only one thing you have to do. Drop the conflict. Conflict is keeping you alive. Any kind of conflict. Anger, incompletion, hatred, jealousy, whatever you know. about any person, about any situation. Let go that. That's all. Okay, that is in my dream. Let me wake up. I am going to wake me up this time. I am going to wake me up. Consciously look at that person. Look at that situation. This is happening in my dream. The financial loss or physical loss of a person or whatever you're going through is a dream. Let me wake up by living in the now. If I let go the conflict only, I can be in Smarnatha Mukti. I can be in the complete space of oneness with Paramashiva. If I hold on that, I cannot grasp this. The brain will not grasp. You cannot have that and now. You either have that or now. You choose. You want suffering or you want now. In now, the conflict cannot happen. That is a dream. You have to declare whatever you're going through is a dream. Now is the moment without any gap. When I chant the Mahavakya, I wake up to reality. Swamiji says in few days, he will liberate you. You will be enlightened. You be in the now and constant remembrance of Paramashiva, that I am Paramashiva. Constant remembrance and chant the Mahavakya. Contemplate only on these truths. Again and again contemplate. How is this happening simultaneously? How is this happening spontaneously? When you do that, the mind dissolves. Mind cannot hold so much of complicated theories. It can only hold one problem and eat you constantly. That's all it does. Especially when somebody shouts at you that whole day. How can she shout? What is she saying? How is this true? She's lying. Repeated thought are repeated more often. So matter cannot do anything to you. You have to become energy. Then only you levitate. Matter, as long as you're matter, you are pulled in gravity. You cannot levitate. You cannot see large amount of materialization and manifesting in next level, next dimension. The Swamiji has been working on this past 2 years with us. In the courtyard, he started this only. But now only we are understanding what he is trying to give us. More and more you live in the now. More and more you remember him in the now. And let go your conflict. Hey, I hate this man. No. I don't know even this man. I am only in the Paramashiva space. Everything I know is only a conflict. Past is only conflict. I am forgetting everything. It's okay. Nothing will happen. You will not miss anything concrete on you. Let Paramashiva possess being in the now. Establish again and again. No. This person did this bad to me. I am now completing with now. I don't know that dream. That dream is a lie. Let's complete. It doesn't even exist. Now come to back to now. Now hold everything beautiful. I love everybody. Get into now and see the dream come with conflict free. In the now, constantly. Again and again have Mahavakya to liberate yourself. So without any gap, being in the now, no conflict and the right context that I am Paramashiva will liberate us completely, make us manifest all the powers of Paramashiva. So here we are going to take a few minutes now and write down the incompletions that we have. Any incompletion that you have, write down, look at from the now. How beautifully Swamiji has given us the rahasya. In the now, nothing. Nothing is there. Nothing. You have woken up from the dream. In the now, you have already woken up. That is why it is so simple. That is why it is as simple as a blink of an eye. The minute you decide to be in the now, that's all the final decision. After that, only Paramashiva possesses you. You don't have to make a decision. He will make all the decision what you want. He'll drive you wherever you want. That's what it means. He is going to want fulfilling your whole life. All you need to do is decide to live in the now. Understand whatever thoughts you're getting, it is only a dream. am shifting from matter to energy. I am no more living here. I live instead. We can have the Mahavakya.
Om Nithyananda Paramashivam, 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 Om Nithyananda Paramashivam.
Oh,
Yes, playing the sutra.
The Shastra Pramana for the power of materialization is taken from the Shiva Sutra, Sutra 1.19. Shakti Sandhane Sharirotpatihi. Shakti Sandhane Sharirotpatihi.
So beautiful that Swamiji has given the sutra. Again and again we are playing so that we really catch the whole thing that Swamiji has given. Like large amount of materialization and levitation happening in all of us. So, and the time component also. So here this is absolutely great. Aiming, fixing, Shakti, oneness. All these words are so well defined. The Shakti is the energy, which is the now. The Shakti is the energy, which is the now. The aiming, your context, and fixing in the now, constantly contemplating and fixing on the self. You're very clear, I want to become Paramashiva. You're very clear, I want to be enlightened. I want to be consciousness. I want to be Paramashiva. So you hold that space. I am going to be in the now. I have removed everything which is conflict. That is a dream. In the dream, somebody does anything, what does happen? Nothing happens. Now I'm waking up. Now, right now, right now, right now. Every moment now. Without any gap, I'm going to hold the oneness space with Paramashiva. It's not Sunya, but all the five phases of Paramashiva is happening in that now. So zillions of years raises and everything goes into the all the five phases. And right now, without gap is happening. So I am going to live that space as my reality. My decision from today, I am living that reality of oneness. I am my decision, that is the space of Paramashiva, that is eternity, that is Nityananda, that is the Shakti, that is the energy, all falls into place if you understand now is the moment. So I'm going to live that space. So the embodiment of which is cognized, it doesn't say you cognized. It says embodiment of that is cognized and willed. Your sankalpa, it's not a big sankalpa, just you have to be in the moment, aware, alive. No, be aware, alive, constant smarnatha mukti, constant remembrance of the guru, constant remembrance of the mahavakya, the higher dimension of you, all the phases of Paramashiva, the zillions of years which is happening, contemplating on that, holding that oneness, I am in now. I am only holding this again and again and again. Whenever thoughts come, no, that is a dream. Again, I'm dreaming. Get back. I am consciously doing this exercise. When I'm doing that, simply I'll open up to Paramashiva, to manifest as Para Shakti, the Kali dimension, Kala dimension through me. And simply I will manifest all the powers in next level. So we are going to post the instruction now. Here, contemplate on this again and again. Zillions of years are implanted inside the now. Now is the moment of Srishti, Stiti, Samhara, Tobara, Anugraha. Meditate on now, the moment. And deeply, Swamiji says, till your being vibrates, you chant the Mahavakya. Not loudly, but your being should vibrate. Your intense search, intense cherishing, intense, how you want something very badly, many times you want something. Like that, very badly you want now, the space of now. And hold that as your cognition and let Paramashiva happen and we become the whole space of Para Shakti manifesting through us. So absolute unclutching from conflicts, holding that oneness space, the space of creation, all the dimension of Paramashiva, the context is I am Paramashiva. Again and again, living in the now, moment to moment to moment, without any gap, and chanting the Mahavakya till my being vibrates. I'm going to manifest all these powers. So let's start with chanting. Let's sit straight. Visualize Swamiji in your third eye. Your back, neck and head and spine in a straight line. Deeply pray to Swamiji with humble gratitude. Humbleness is less of you. That is humbleness. Surrender is as you give up all your conflict, all your dream, whatever you are going through, you surrender, you empower yourself. That Paduka, the Swamiji's lotus feet, literally liberates you. So constantly surrender every thought that you are happening. Ask for guidance. Swamiji, I want to be Paramashiva. I want to be one with you. I want that as my deep earning. Let me live in the now. Deep, humble gratitude and request. Make this as a reality for me. Hold that beautiful prayer space and start. Simply that will become reality in all of us. So let's start. Let's sit straight. Visualize Swamiji in the third eye. And start the deep chanting.
Paramashivam.
Yes. Let me share the poll. Yes. You can share the detail. Yes, please go ahead and everybody take it. Yeah, just the manifestation. So beautiful, 6 of 8 and 88%. Yes, if more people could share it, then it will be nice. That's beautiful. Go ahead and share all that powerful cognition and power manifestation in the Kailash Kotiyar Manifesting Power Group. And share this group with as many as people so that you can bring more people to satsang, what Swamiji's Leela is. And you can tell them these are the Leelas of Swamiji, how these. This is a group where you share everything, and there is a page. You can share the page with everybody, and simply you can invite people for satsang. You can tell them, hey, see how many things I have manifested and all my group has manifested so many powers, and you can also experience all this. When we just get into that beautiful space of oneness with Swamiji, we manifest all these things. You can also come and experience all these things. Call everybody to satsang. As many people, especially this week, Swamiji said, whoever is blessed to be enlightened, only they will be listening to the satsang. So don't miss the satsang for next few days, Swamiji has told. With these powerful cognition and power manifestation, again and again, post your powerful cognitions and contemplate on it and share the powerful manifestation from all these things. This is Paramashiva manifestation. Literally, he is manifesting as you. You becoming him. The beautiful space that you are him. So whatever your experience is, go ahead and share that beautiful happening in your world. And share that with everybody, your friends, your family, and tell them, hey, it's all true. It's all real. Go ahead. Come for the satsang. And you will simply see such beautiful changes happen in your life, in health, wealth, everything. Because you're changing your master software. Once you change your master software, everything else which is linked to it, all that which is linked, your relationship, your finance, your even your dream, your deep sleep, everything will change. The whole world changes with you, the Pai of Paramashiva. Once you start living conflict-free in the now, loving everybody as Paramashiva, just from the space of now, just a newborn, that Swamiji says, every moment is your newborn. Living that beautiful space of oneness with Paramashiva, you become Paramashiva. So that's beautiful. So let's surrender all that Shakti into Swamiji's lotus feet. More and more, let the Shaktis become the Buddhi, the higher truth in me. And let's, with gratitude, surrender all the Shaktis to Swamiji's lotus feet. With that, let's sit straight, visualize Swamiji in the third eye, and end with the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Paramashivam Paduka Arpanamastu. Om Nityanandam. Thank you, Swamiji. Thank you, Paramashiva. See you all in satsang. Nityananda.